O almirante Craig Feller, chefe do Comando Sul dos Estados Unidos, deu uma entrevista coletiva na manhã desta quinta-feira em Brasília. O almirante comentou as relações próximas entre os militares americanos e brasileiros. O almirante está de saída. Ele se aposenta em outubro após 38 anos de serviço na Marinha. Ele não quis comentar. Os veículos fumacentos do recente desfile bolsonarista ou se constituem uma ameaça às milícias do Rio de Janeiro.
I'm nearing the end of a 38-year career in the United States military, and this will be my last overseas official trip in that 38-year career, and nearing 3 years as the commander of the United States Southern Command. And we carefully and strategically chose Brazil for that visit because of the importance of our long-standing relationship that goes back to World War II, and the exceptional work that we have done together, military to military, over the many years since. And the utmost respect that I have, my command has, and the entire U.S. military has for the professionals in the Brazilian Armed Forces. So the purpose of this visit is to renew and reinvigorate that relationship, which we've made great progress on in my 3 years, and continue to strengthen it. Relationships only go one of two ways, and we are committed to making this relationship stronger. We've reviewed the accomplishments of the last 3 years and talked about things that we want to work on together. We start all the conversations with our education programs, where we exchange officers and enlisted at our top schools, and that includes U.S. students coming to Brazil. Brazil's four colleges are world class, and I visit tomorrow the Superior War College in Rio, and I'll speak there. It'll be my third visit to that war college. It's a gold standard of war colleges. Talk about our exercise program. In 2019, Brazil hosted UNITAS, which is the longest serving maritime exercise in U.S. history, but Brazil hosted, and Brazil will host UNITAS again in 2022. And UNITAS is a great name for what we do as militaries. What we strive to do is just achieve unity and peace by working together.
Admiral, if I may, I might make two quick questions. You talk a lot about preparedness. Early this month, the Brazilian government organized a parade of military vehicles, which was supposed to be a demonstration of strength. And what we saw was a parade of Navy vehicles that were leaking smoke. In terms of preparedness, how much has the Brazilian equipment, the Brazilian military equipment, evolved in these last 3 years that you've been followed in Southcon? The second question I have is, you're talking about military groups, about transnational criminal organizations. With the support of the recent Brazilian government, the import and sale of fire weapons has tripled in the last 2 years. And Brazil's Senator Flávio Bolsonaro, which is the eldest son of the president, he has ties to a militia group in Rio. He actually employed in his cabinet the former wife and the mother of a now deceased militia member, Capitão Adriano, which was killed last year. How concerned are you about militia groups in Rio de Janeiro?
So when we talk about education and training, which is the key, it's the most important thing we do in the military, is educate and train our teams to be ready. So that training involves maintenance training, and maintenance, ensuring that our equipment is ready day in and day out to meet the range of threats is important. It's also challenging. Just think about how difficult the maintenance is on all of your own vehicles and cars, and then take something that has high tech in it, different types of engines that are designed for high performance. And so this comes up in all our conversations. I'm not aware of the parade or anything associated with the parade, but every nation works hard. The United States works very hard to maintain our gear, and it is always both a strength and an area that needs improvement. And I know that was a topic of discussion here with the Brazilian. We do maintenance exchanges as part of our training and education program. We look into the future as to how we do security cooperation. And when the Brazil makes a decision for foreign military sales to the United States, which they do, and we welcome it because U.S. equipment is built to last and it comes with guarantees and maintenance and training, we talk about what that looks like for sustainability into the future. And that's part of your second question. As I mentioned earlier, I've studied the employment and the Brazilian Armed Forces, and I look at my own force, and I look at the ethical use of that force, and I'm confident that the professionals that I'm working with are working hard to do the right thing every day, and I I'm not privy or haven't studied the details of any interactions with militia and members of the president's family.